How's it going, everyone, and welcome to a very special Flesh and Blood video here on Channel Fireball. My name is Kel, and I run the YouTube channel Red Zone Rogue. If you like Flesh and Blood or any other card game, I cover a lot of card games, definitely go check out my YouTube channel Red Zone Rogue, where I actually was able to spoil this card right here, Shiver. And so that's what we're going to talk about today. We're going to talk about the three first cards revealed for Tales of Aria. Currently, I think I'm one of the only like two people in the world outside of Legend Story Studios who have these. So I think this is gonna be a pretty fun exclusive thing to talk to you guys about. The only person is DM Armada, and Kitchen Table TCG should have some, but his package was delayed a little bit. So I think it's just me and DM Armada who have these currently. So yeah, we're gonna talk about these. I'm gonna show these off in person, and well, as in person as I can be through a video, and give me my opinions on all these cards, which are really sweet. If you did not see the spoilers, the spoiler videos for any of these, I think they turned out incredibly well. We had like a little tournament kind of thing, a ultimate pit fight game, multiplayer game to determine who gets to spoil these. Long story short, Steven, DM Armada, got to spoil Lexi, I got to spoil Shiver, and Kitchen Table TCG got to spoil Weave Lightning. Check out each of those channels for the videos. I'm really, really proud of my Shiver spoiler video, especially in the amount of time that I had to do it. So all that aside, let's actually start talking about these. I am going to take these out of the sleeves because I want you to see what they look like in their true glory. I had these actually all in hard cases, but you know what? I figured for this video, let's dress them down a little bit and make sure that everyone can see what they really, really look like without any plastic covering them up, because they are gorgeous. These are the promo cards that you actually can get in the September Armory kits. At your local game stores, Channel Fireball, anyone holding events, you can get these there. So let's start off by talking about, let's gingerly pick up Lexi. This is Lexi Livewire. Like I said, this is the promo card that you can get at your September Armory events. This one obviously is just a token in the regular set. So Lexi Livewire is an elemental ranger hero with the 4 hand size and 40 life. She says, essence of ice and lightning. You may have ice and lightning cards in your deck, which is so cool. Once per turn action, turn a face down card in your arsenal face up. If it's a lightning card, your next attack this turn gains go again, dude. If it's an ice card, create a frostbite token under target hero's control. We don't know what frostbite tokens do yet. And then has go again. I think this is amazing. She has a built-in way to give attacks go again, and it's really interesting. It just says turn a face down card in your arsenal face up. If it's a lightning card, your next attack, not that card, but your next attack. So you can turn down, you can turn up, say, Weave Lightning. So you had, say you had this card, Weave Lightning, which is a lightning action. You had this card face down in your arsenal. You could turn it face up, and then your Remorseless that you play, like your next Remorseless that you play or whatever, has go again, which is super cool. I mean, maybe to make it a little bit easier, let's say your Command and Conquer, right, has go again, which is really, really cool. I like this quite a bit. I know a lot of people, after seeing this card, they're like, oh, she makes the Skullbone cross wrap less good because the cross wrap also cares about turning face down cards face up. Keep in mind, this is a once per turn ability, and so is the Skullbone cross wrap. So if you can somehow get 2 cards into your arsenal face down, and we're gonna talk about that with Shiver here. If you can somehow get 2 cards face down into your arsenal, then you can do it both. Like, you can turn both of them up and get different effects. So please keep that in mind. I think a lot of people are overlooking that they're both once per turn effects. So I think there is some utility there, and it doesn't make Skullbone cross wrap completely useless. And also gives you the options too. If you need to opt, right, then you can opt with the cross wrap, or if you just want to get go again, you can do that, or whatever the frostbite token thing does. I could speculate here what I think it does. Probably debilitates your opponent somehow, maybe makes their actions cost 1 more, or they don't get go again or something, or maybe only get 1 go again, something like that. But in any case, I love Lexi. I think she's fantastic. She's instantly one of my favorite heroes. I already love Ranger. Ranger was like tied for my favorite class with Runeblade, and I think Lexi is really gonna push it over, make it my favorite class. I know it's easy to say, oh, the new hotness is your favorite, but man, I've been running Ranger ever since the beginning. I've had now three Ranger preview cards. So yeah, Ranger is very near and dear to me. And look at these borders, man. Look at these beautiful borders. really, really cool. So that is Lexi Livewire. The next card was my own spoiler, Shiver. So Shiver is an elemental ranger weapon, bow, is a two-handed bow. So only currently Lexi can use this, Azalea cannot use this, which is kind of a bummer, but this card is the best bow they've ever made. It says once per turn, instant, once per turn, you can do this on your opponent's turn. For a single resource, you may put an arrow card from your hand face up into an empty arsenal zone you control. An empty arsenal zone, which heavily implies that there could be more than one empty arsenal zone that you control, which then implies that you could have two, feasibly, face down cards in your arsenal, so you can activate Lexi and the Skullbone Crossrope. So that's what I was trying to get at here. The Shiver doesn't actually put it face down, Shiver puts it face up, but if you could somehow put them face down with reload or, you know, end of turn shenanigans, you can definitely do that. I really like this being an instant, by the way. So after your turn is done, you can draw up, right? And then on your opponent's turn, if they're gonna do some shenanigans to you, like, I don't know, make you discard the cards with Crippling Crush or something, you can, in response, put them into your arsenal so you don't have to worry about that. So that's a very important thing to note. And it could have some other applications as we see more cards from Tales of Aria. And what does it actually do after you do that? So the arrow gets either plus one or dominate, which is insane. Dude, that's so good. Built-in dominate on the weapon. And then Lexi has built-in go again. So if you can somehow pair these together, which I think is going to be quite easy, you can give your attacks go again and dominate, which is disgusting. Lexi seems like a really good hero to push damage through, especially when combined with Shiver here. So yeah, that's Shiver. Once again, I highly recommend watching. Of course I recommend it, but I spent a lot of time working on the spoiler video. I only had one day to do it, so I really hauled butt to get that done in time. And I did some Red Zone Rogue lore. I'm actually from Wyoming. And so did a little bit of my country boy voice there. So yeah, if you want to see my Shiver video and hear my country voice, then definitely check out my video on Shiver. Anyway, hey man, I've lived in Oregon so long, my voice is like very Oregonian now. Anyway, we have Weave Lightning. So this card I think is amazing, actually. And also look at the border, very interesting. It's actually different colors than Lexi's border. So I think each of the elemental types is gonna have a different color border. So I think once we see like a frost action, so this is a lightning action, we do know that Lexi hints at ice cards. I think the ice border will be the blues in here and not the yellows and reds. Anyway, what does Weave Lightning do other than looking freaking awesome? Zero cost, boom. I'm on board, zero cost. Blocks for two, not great, but you know. The next lightning or elemental attack action card you play this turn. It's very interesting that it says lightning or elemental. So I wonder if there's gonna be just generic elemental attack actions that aren't lightning or ice or whatever else they have. That heavily implies that. So we're probably gonna get lightning, ice, probably one other type. My guess is like nature, I don't actually know. And then some generic ones that are just like elemental, which I think could be really cool. And it says, it gets plus three. And if it's fused, it gets go again. So base levels, right? Regardless of the fused shenanigans, it gets plus three. Zero for plus three is Nimblism, and that's good. Nimblism is very playable. I play in a lot of like aggro heavy decks. Zero for plus three is a very, very, very good going rate. Zero for plus three and go again is absurdly good. So I think this card's gonna be fantastic. By the way, this card is a rare in the set, where these two are both tokens. So these two are gonna be very easy to get. This is gonna be rare, which is gonna be also pretty easy to get. So let's talk about Fused a little bit. We don't know anything about Fused. I have some guesses on what I think Fused does or could do, but it's all pure speculation. I would be willing to bet, since Shiver heavily alludes at multiple cards in your arsenal, I wonder if Fuse has to do with that, if you can possibly have multiple cards in your arsenal, and maybe the card that has the keyword Fuse or something, if you do it, maybe you can also do the other card at the same time. I'm not sure. I think it's gonna be something like that, like combining attack actions together to do some sort of like joint attack using only one action. That would be my guess. I think it's gonna be really cool. I'm very, very curious to see how Fuse works. I think this card is really good. Dude, I cannot wait to draft and play this set. I cannot wait for the Calling Las Vegas. It's gonna be so cool. Other than the fact that I'm gonna be doing commentary, you know, for Channel Fireball in the booth, I'm still gonna be participating in the world premiere event of Tales of Aria, and I am unbelievably excited for that. Unbelievably excited for that. So yeah, let me know in the comments down below what you think of all these cards. Like I said, these are gonna be the promos for the September Armory kits. So if you wanna get your hands on these, just, you know, compete in some local events and do well, and you might end up with some really cool cards. If you just want the regular versions of these cards, all three of these are gonna be very, very easy to get, you know, tokens and rares with Tales of Aria in September. Man, I'm so excited for this set. I cannot wait to play with these new cards. This is only like one, this is only three cards, and I'm so pumped for this. I'm so pumped for this. So thank you so much for watching, everyone. Like I said, let me know what you think of these in the comments down below, and I will see you next time for some more Flesh and Blood content here on Channel Fireball. I almost forgot about it. If you're gonna pick up any Tales of Aria stuff, you can use my promo code at Channel Fireball, Rogue, at checkout, and it goes and supports me. So I would greatly appreciate that. You can use that promo code for anything on Channel Fireball, Channel Flesh and Blood, MetaZoo, Pokemon, Magic, any of that stuff, and it goes and supports me. So if you wanna buy some Tales of Aria stuff and you wanna support me and what I do, thank you. Thank you so much. Anyway, have a good one, everyone. We'll see you next time.